How's it going, everybody? It is Mikey here, or YouTube Dude, and today I'm going to be talking about Ghost. Now, if we're joining this gameplay, it's already getting started, and it is not going very good for me. I think I'm running lightweight here. I have the long barrel on the MCSC, and I am just losing gunfights. And finally, I decided to switch up my class. I just had enough of it. And then we're going to see the final straw, which is I see this guy, I shoot him, and he just casually snipes me as if I wasn't even there. And actually, the kill cam, it doesn't even show me shooting the dude. And then right there, that is when I realized that, okay, so either I'm really, really bad at this game, or I'm lagging, or, you know, just something's going on. So I had this class that I had already built up, which is Ghost and Lightweight. Two perks that complement each other amazingly. Now, if you notice on the top left, my little triangle, it dims when I'm moving. That means I'm off the radar. Now, I know a lot of people already knew this. This is for the new people. I'm here to help. Okay, if you already knew this, then just sit tight. I'm going to explain Ghost really quick. Ghost basically will keep you off the map, you know, if you're moving. That is why a lightweight is such a good complement to that. Whatever class you're building, you want to build up stuff that complements it. My tier 3, I have engineer and extreme conditioning. You know, engineer is going to delay any bouncing betties, but at the same time, you can actually see them. If you have a PDA, you can hack them, which will help build up your kill streak, which is why PDA is so amazing. This class is not perfect. I don't have the PDA. I have an RPG on my back, which I don't even pull out once. I think I forget I have it because I'm running scavenger. So I'm not perfect. So by watching this gameplay, I'm actually learning myself. I learned, okay, no more RPG. I should probably put on a PDA. That might help me because look, I'm shooting at a bouncing Betty that put me on the minimap when I could have just used a PDA and it could have been done and over with. So both of us, you and I, we're both learning here. Learn from my mistakes. But what I did do right is the combination of Ghost and Lightweight is so powerful. Look at the map. It's just me out here. All my other teammates are on the other side, and which means I am going to be getting a lot of kills, causing a lot of, you know, havoc out here. Now for my killstreak setup, this is one of my favorite killstreak setups. Definitely give it a try. Now, Lightning Strike, everyone already knows it is probably, if not the best, one of the best kill streaks in the game. It's just so easy to get a multi-kill, get at least one kill. It has such a good, you know, return on investment, if you will. And then after that, I go on to my favorite kill streak, the AGR. It's not the best, but it's fun to control that little robot. And here I start experimenting with something. Now, because my gameplay was just so bad in the beginning, I know that I'm losing gunfights. And so I get into my head that I need to flank. I need to get the hell away from my teammates. My teammates are enemies too. I need to get the hell away from them. And that's what I do. I'm just so focused on getting away from them. I almost missed that guy back there. Now, onto the kill streaks. AGR is amazing, but do not call it in until you get your next one, which is the stealth chopper. These two are just deadly together, and they are such a pain in the ass for the other team. And I don't take control of it, and I'm not sure that is the best thing to do with the AGR. Now, when I do have control of the AGR, I get many more kills with it. However, I have noticed that when I toss down the AGR, that's causing a distraction along with the stealth chopper that allows me to continuously flank. You see, I'm just running a big circle on the map. Here, my iPad glitches out and I try to call in that chopper really quick and escape. But for whatever reason, it locked up and then that guy killed me. So that was a bummer. I was actually complaining to my teammates. I'm like, what the hell? My iPad glitched. And here again, I'm shooting at this Betty when I could have just pulled up my PDA. So this class is going to take some tweaks, although I'm about to prestige today, so I'm going to lose it all anyways. But the point is making the most out of Ghost, and that is running and gunning. And so maybe you're not used to this. Maybe you're used to, you know, being real passive. You gotta get over that. To be a better Call of Duty player, you're gonna have to run around like a chicken without a head. Sometimes, not all the time. That's how you learn the maps. Because sometimes I run into a crowd of people and I can walk backwards and into a room because I already know this game. I already know the maps very well from running around like a chicken with its head cut off. You just got to do that sometimes. With every Call of Duty, there is a class that lets you run and gun. And it's usually the Ghost class or the Cold-Blooded class. Give Ghost a try with Lightweight. It is so deadly. Get rid of any, you know, long barrel or any, you know, red dot sights. That was my mistake at the very beginning. Definitely just go with the fast mag attachment since you're going to be all up in their biz. If you could take 3 seconds to leave a thumbs up, I'd really appreciate it. And I will see you guys later. So it's kind of funny. A bunch of YouTubers I've noticed, they have been complaining. They don't like the skill-based matchmaking because they can't get those gameplays for YouTube where they can impress people, you know, by going 101.